Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to talk about some vocabulary and relationships that exist between angles. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to identify angle types and relationships within a given image. First, we'll complete one example of identifying angle types, and then we'll complete two examples comparing angles to each other. You'll also learn all the vocabulary you need as we go. Our first example is going to use three vocabulary words: acute, right, and obtuse. Acute angles are between 0 degrees and 90 degrees. Right angles are exactly 90 degrees, and obtuse angles are between 90 degrees and 180 degrees. Take a moment now to write the definitions for these in your notes template. Then, underneath those definitions is a practice problem to try. See what you can come up with on your own. Here's that practice problem. It's said to list all acute, right, and obtuse angles in the image. Let's go over the answers to this and see if you are able to find all of them. I actually want to start by going through all the right angles first, even though that's probably not the order you found them in. We know angle EAF is a right angle because of the symbol on the picture. And if one of these is, then the other three angles are too. So, did you have those as your answers for the right angles? Did you call this angle EAF or angle FAE? Remember, either is correct. And if you ever write your angle a different way than I do, it's okay, as long as the vertex is in the middle. I'm going to call it angle EAF. This right angle can be angle SAF. Then we have angle BAS and angle BAE. Take a moment to check your work. Then we'll move on to the acute angles. Acute angles are less than 90 degrees. And since angle BAE is a right angle, any of the angles contained within it would have to be smaller than 90 degrees. That means angle BAC is acute. Angle BAN is acute. Angle CAN is acute. And angle NAE. And angle EAC. Whew! Did you get all five of those? Pause now if you need a little more time with this. Were you able to find all the obtuse angles? Remember that obtuse angles are more than 90 degrees. So if we can take a right angle and add an acute angle to it, that'll make it obtuse. For example, here is a right angle, and adding this little angle to it will make it more than 90 degrees, but still less than 180 degrees. That gives us angle NAF as an obtuse angle. We also have angle CAF, angle CAS, angle NAS, Oh wait, that's it this time. Whew, that wasn't too bad. Don't forget, you can always pause or rewind if you want more time to review this section. Next, we'll talk about some ways that angles can relate to each other. The two terms we're starting with are complementary and supplementary. Complementary angles add up to 90 degrees. And supplementary angles add up to 180 degrees. And remember, for both of these, you can only add two angles together. Add these definitions to your notes template and try finding angles like these in the practice problem. Let's see if you're able to find the complementary angles. Remember that angle BAE was a 90 degree angle. So, two angles within it that take up all of angle BAE would add up to 90 degrees. like angles CAB and CAE. Or we could say angles NAB and angle NAE. Something important to remember is that the angles don't have to be adjacent to be complementary. Adjacent angles share a ray. But if these were split apart and weren't adjacent, they would still be complementary. All right, that was a lot to add to your notes, so why don't you pause the video now and take some time to catch up? Then get ready to check your answers for the supplementary angles. Supplementary angles add up to 180 degrees. We have angles EAF and EAB. They add up to 180 degrees since 90 plus 90 is 180. Angles NAF and NAB are also supplementary. And the same is true for angle CAF and angle CAB. Did you get these answers on your own? If not, pause the video now so you can catch up. Also, remember that even though all the examples we've seen here involve adjacent angles, that's not a requirement for angles to be supplementary. As long as the two angles add up to 180 degrees, like these angles, then they're supplementary. The last two relationships we're going to cover in this lesson are vertical angles and linear pairs. Vertical angles are opposite angles created by intersecting lines. Think about two lines crossing each other. Which angles here would you say are opposite to each other? These are vertical angles, and so are these. And linear pairs are supplementary angles that are also adjacent. We learned about supplementary angles a moment ago, but now imagine that the two supplementary angles have to share a ray. Basically, these two angles are supplementary, but they're not a linear pair. And these two angles are supplementary and are a linear pair. All right. See if that's enough information for you to complete the example in your notes template. Pause the video and give it a try. I'm sure you noticed that the angles were labeled differently than what you're used to. Instead of always having to use three letters to name our angles, sometimes we could just use one number. It's a nice shortcut, so I figured it was a good time to share it with you. Anyways, let's see if you found the vertical angles. These two lines intersect to form angles, and two opposite angles formed are angles 1 and 5. A cool thing about vertical angles is that they're always congruent to each other. Do angles 1 and 5 look like they have the same angle measure? Yes, vertical angles are always congruent. And the other vertical angles here are angle 6 and angles 2, 3, and 4 put together. But it's not proper math grammar to write an angle this way, so we'll have to use letters for this one. It's time to finish our notes off with linear pairs, so pause the video if you need more time. We defined linear pairs as supplementary angles that are adjacent to each other. Another way to think of this is angles that form a line, like angle 1 and angle CAF. They form a line. They add up to 180 degrees and are adjacent to each other. There are a lot of linear pairs in this picture, so I'm just gonna leave you with the key here. Then you can go at your own pace and compare my answers with yours to see how you did. Pause the video now and take as long as you need. Now you can use all sorts of vocabulary about angles and angle relationships. In the next lesson, we'll get to use this vocabulary to solve some problems. It's been fun, and I'll see you later. Hey.